Hello all, hope you all are doing great. So this is a small video on IR emitters, which is there in your unit 1 of basic electronics. So before starting with that IR emitters, hope you all are staying at home, stay safe, don't roam around, start studying something, stay fit, okay? Fine, so let us start with the basic thing, IR emitters. So basically, the right side structure, whatever you are seeing, this structure is nothing but a structure of an IR emitter, wherein you can see there is a P-type material and an N-type material sandwiched together. So it is nothing but, it is actually a diode, which is made up of a solid state gallium arsenide. And when I apply a potential across this diode, means to say when I make it forward bias, that is positive to the p-type and negative to the n-type, the holes and electrons recombine, and this recombination process actually creates photons. Basically, the recombinations of holes and electrons within this structure converts that recombination energy into a photon energy, and few photons will be getting escaped out of that particular structure, and few photons might be getting stuck within the structure, and that is how basically IR is being emitted. For that case, it is not just IR. IR is just one wavelength. I can have different wavelengths getting emitted if I make my structure with the help of different solid state materials. So basically, this is a generic example of an IR emitter, and the emission of photons we call, or we term here it as, the flux or the radiant flux. Okay, so basically how a structure looks like, you can see here the p-type and n-type material, where this one is a contact for the negative terminal, and this is internally I'll be having a positive contact, and this will be placed within a collimating structure or a small structure, and that structure is enclosed with some epoxy resin. Okay, and whenever I make this particular PN diode as forward biased, there is emission of radiation or photons because of the recombinations of holes and electrons within that particular structure. So we usually call this as pellet. Okay, and the interior structure is a parabolic reflecting surface. The symbol how we represent this is a normal diode with the arrow marks. So arrow mark here corresponds to, it is going to emit some form of light. Here it is IR, it might be different wavelengths. That's what this particular picture shows. Basically the top one you can see, it is actually an IR emitting, light emitting diode, LED, IR emitting, because IR is not visible to a naked eye, whereas the different wavelengths of light which is visible to naked eye, you have seen all red, green, blue LEDs, the TV screen or whatever the LED screens that you have different wavelengths being created using those LEDs. So basically this is a basic working procedure of an LED. So if you want to see the flux, radiant flux in milliwatts with respect to the forward bias current that I apply to a device, so here is a graph. As you can see here, as and when I increase this current, okay, this is IF, is the forward current that is being fed to my diode, it is in milliamps. You can see the flux. Flux is nothing but the amount of emission of light, okay, the photons in terms of milliwatt. Okay, as I increase the current, you can see the flux or the emission of photons keeps on increasing. So this is one relation, and the second one is how the radiation pattern looks like. Basically there are two types of radiation pattern. Radiation pattern means to say how my photons are getting emitted, or what is the radiation it takes place. So basically there are two types of structures that we usually use. One is a flat glass window, which is usually used in homes and lighting purposes, which you would have already seen, which will be having a broader emission of radiation. So these are the ones which I was explaining, like you'll be having broader emission of radiations, whereas the one which you are seeing internally, the thinner one, okay, or the narrower beam, So you can see this beam is narrower. Okay, this are used or manufactured using an internal collimating system. Where are this used? Okay, these are basically used in systems like wherever I want to have a narrow beam of emission. Any guess where it might be used? Okay, I'll help you out. So you would have seen projector headlamps in vehicles or the torch and all. So there you would have seen structure something similar to this. So this is a collimating structure where the light will be getting emitted in a narrower beam. So this is all about IR emitters theory. So let's hope that we'll see some practical applications also. I'll try to make a video of that. Thank you.
This is a flat PET LED source wherein you don't have any collimating structure, so the beam will be very broader in the sense, once you turn on, you have a broad range of light being spread across and you can have a very broader sense of light. So here I have a torch, which is a LED torch, and if you see this structure internally, it is having a collimating structure. So obviously, if I turn this on, you can see you have a straighter light or a narrower beam of light going there. It is not spreading across. You can see it is not spreading across and it is going very straight or in a narrower sense. So this sort of lights are having collimating structure, hence the narrower beam. Ta-da!